I'm gonna give you three key ways that you can learn how to throw faster. And we're gonna start right now. So throwers are always asking, how can I throw faster? I feel slow, I don't understand why I'm so slow. And we've gotta think about, all right, if I'm a shot putter or I'm a discus thrower, what does that even mean, right? We need to establish what that actually means. And then we also need to establish where we are in training. And if we're doing high volume work, and if we're getting, you know, central nervous system fatigue, and that could impact our slow feelings in the circle. So to actually throw faster, we have to be more precise with our movement. We have to have very concise patterning that will enhance our ability to get to positions a little bit tighter. So if we're a glider, we need to get our right foot down a little bit faster in the middle. We need to get our left foot down, if we're a right-handed thrower, a little bit quicker at the front. So then we can be in double support slightly longer, and then in turn generate more force, which helps us accelerate the implement quicker. So these are some key concepts that to understand what goes into throwing faster, that's gonna help us then solve the problem of actually being faster in the circle. And so that takes us right into that first key factor. We have to improve our technique. If we know what that technical problem is, then we are going to be able to enhance that speed. So there's a couple key factors here, and I'm gonna throw a really big term right at you. And this is from someone named Charles Sherrington, and you can look this research up, and also Thomas Brown, and it's called central pattern generators. And so central pattern generators are instinctual packets of neurons which are responsible for rhythmic patterning. And so if we are looking to improve our technique, we first have to chunk that technique. So that might mean let's work on the back of the circle first. Then let's work on the middle and the back together. Then let's work on the middle to the front. And then let's work on the entire movement. So now we can understand what's going on from a technical patterning position, and then try to develop those central pattern generators, or try to develop those neurons to inhibit one another so that you can actually execute your technique as effectively as possible. And so some of the key concepts, if you're a rotational shot putter, improve that ability to cut that right, get balance out of the back around that left side, cut that right down. And if that right comes down faster, ideally we want to get off of the left leg faster. If we get off of the left leg faster, it should come down quicker at the front. Our technique will improve, and the speed of the movement will improve because we're more efficient with our patterning. That takes us directly into that second key concept, and that means throwing variable weighted implements, okay? So a lot of people will say, well, you throw heavy implements to enhance your strength, and you throw light implements to enhance your speed. And this is true to a point, but we have to remember that if these movements with a heavy implement, if they're happening at, you know, 11 to 12 meters per second, and light implements are happening at, you know, 14 to 15 meters per second, this is with elite shot putters, they're both gonna have a drastic impact on enhancing speed, because your body is learning the specific patterning that it needs to execute those technical movements, going back to that aspect number one, but it's also learning how to coordinate really quickly and take those massive muscles that we're building through maximal voluntary actions in the weight room, and then in turn, we're applying that directly into the technique by throwing heavy or throwing light. So ideally, a coach needs to understand, okay, if we throw heavy, this is what happens to this specific person. If we throw light, this is what happens to this specific person, and they enhance their overall coordination, and in turn, they end up throwing faster. And then finally, that takes us into that third key factor, and this is gonna be based around rapid rates of coordination. And so we have to think that the best shot putters in the world, Ryan Krauser, he throws so freaking far because he's able to coordinate his muscles at a higher speed than anyone else relative to his size, okay? So, you know, Joe Kovacs might actually be able to recruit just as fast as Krauser, but he's a little bit smaller, so there might be some biomechanical advantages that Krauser has. That would have to be studied a little bit deeper. But if we can think through the patterning of coordination, the entire goal has to be to coordinate as quickly as possible. So that takes us backwards, right? That takes us, if we can coordinate as effectively as possible, we need it to be specific to the movement. That's the first step. That goes to throwing light, throwing heavy, and understanding your technique. If we want to train that in the weight room from another perspective, in just training the skill of rapid coordination, training the skill of co-contractions and pre-flexes, now we have to start to use things like plyometric movements so we can do hurdle hops. We can train technical coordination movements so we can do power cleans, behind the neck jerks, snatches, all these technical coordination variations, which in turn lead to greater rates of coordination. Now we couple that with those hurdle hops, with those double leg bounds, with those single leg bounds, with stair jumps, and then we also factor in doing special strength movements such as half turns with a dumbbell or side medicine ball throws, or even using reflexive strength training movements like a rotational dumbbell drop snatch to a hip lock. All of these types of reflexive movements generate a ton of force and a ton of speed, and it trains your body how to operate at an extremely high rate of force production through semi-autonomous muscular actions. So it's really important to see that getting faster in the circle is really, one, specific to the technique that you're gonna use. Two, it's specific to creating a consistent pattern behind that technique. And then three, training your nervous system and your body to utilize skills such as co-contractions so that you're able to quiet all of the noise and generate a ton of force production in a very short period of time. And those are three key concepts that will help you throw faster. And if you need help with your training, you need help developing a better program so that you can throw faster, you can click on the link down below, head over to throwsuniversity.com, pick up one of our custom throws-based programs to help you become a better shot putter or discus thrower. Until next time, guys, peace.